Arjun opened up a savings account last year and put an initial sum in it. Let M of T denote the account balance, M, measured in dollars, T days since it was opened. What does the statement M of 30 minus M of 0 equaling 100 mean? So before I even look at the choices, let's think about it. This means when you input T equals 30 into your function, you're going to get m of 30. So let me make that clear. So if you say t is equal to 30, you input that into your function m, you are going to get m of 30. So one way to think about it is this is the account balance 30 days since it was opened. This is when t is equal to 30. This is the account balance after 30 days. So let me write that down. Balance after 30 days. Now, by the same logic, this right over here, this is when we put t, when we set t equals 0, this is the balance after 0 days. Or you could say this is the initial balance. Initial balance. So what they're doing, they're taking our balance after 30 days, and from that, they're subtracting the initial balance, and they're saying that that's equal to 100. So there's a couple of ways you could interpret this, and I haven't even looked at these choices yet. We'll see if any of these match up. You could say that your balance after 30 days is $100 more than the initial balance. Or another way to think about it is you've added $100 in the first 30 days. Those are both legitimate ways to think about it. Now let's see which of these choices are consistent with that. 30 days after it was opened, the balance of Arjun's account was equal to 100. No, that's not what that's saying. This statement right over here, that the balance 30 days after opening, this statement right over here, this is equivalent to saying that M of 30, this is the balance after 30 days after it was open, is equal to 100. That's not what they tell us here. They tell us that the difference between the balance after 30 days and the initial balance, that is 100. So we can rule that one out. Arjun had the initial amount of money in his account 30 days after he opened it. So if he had the same amount, if he had the initial amount, let me write this down. So had the initial amount of money, the initial amount of money is M of 0. So they're saying he had the initial amount of money in his account 30 days after he opened it. Well, the amount that he has in his account 30 days after he opened it is M of 30. So if these are the same amounts of money, then this, in order to be consistent with this, you would have had an equation like this. M of 0, the initial amount, is equal to the amount after 30 days. That's not what they told us over here. So we can rule that out. And then finally, we have the choice. Arjun made a profit of $100 over the first 30 days since the account was opened. And that seems reasonable that his balance is $100 higher. The difference between if you take his initial balance and subtract it from his balance after 30 days, it's 100. That this right over here is 100 higher than his initial balance. So it makes sense that maybe he got that profit, I don't know, it's an interest or something else that he got in his bank account over the first 30 days.